Hi, today we will talk about biosynthesis of adrenocortical hormones. Let us begin with the structure of the adrenal gland. The adrenal or the suprarenal gland is located on the top of each kidney. It produces a variety of hormones that includes the steroid hormones and the catecholamines. If we look at the cross section, we find that the adrenal gland is formed of an outer cortex and an inner medulla. The outer cortex is subdivided into three zones: zona glomerulosa, zona fasciculata, and zona reticularis. We can remember this by the mnemonic GFR, from outside to inside. Zona glomerulosa produces mineralocorticoids, mainly aldosterone. Zona fasciculata produces glucocorticoids, mainly cortisol. And zona reticularis produces androgen precursors, mainly dihydroepiandrosterone. The adrenal medulla mainly produces catecholamines such as adrenaline and noradrenaline. It is important to note that the outer zone, that is zona glomerulosa, is mainly stimulated by angiotensin II and extracellular potassium, while the inner two zones, that is zona fasciculata and zona reticularis, are mainly stimulated by ACTH, that is adrenocorticotropic hormone. We can recall that ACTH is a hormone secreted by anterior pituitary gland that regulates the secretion of adrenocortical hormones. Now let us have a look as to what is going on inside the adrenal cortex. So the precursor or the starting point of all steroid hormones is cholesterol. It is a 27-carbon compound. It passes through a chain of reactions to get converted to either 21-carbon compounds or 19-carbon compounds. The 21-carbon compounds are mainly mineralocorticoids and glucocorticoids, while the 19-carbon compounds are the androgens. By mineralocorticoids, we mean that they mainly have effects on salt and water regulation. By glucocorticoids, we mean that they mainly have effects on glucose and protein metabolism. So on the left column, we will look at the synthesis of mineralocorticoids. In the middle column, we will look at the synthesis of glucocorticoids, and on the extreme right, we will observe the synthesis of androgen precursors. So now we begin. In the first step, cholesterol gets converted to a substance called pregnenolone by the action of an enzyme, side chain cleavage enzyme or desmolase. As the name suggests, the side carbon chain is cleaved off or broken off, and the 27-carbon cholesterol becomes 21-carbon pregnenolone. This reaction is regulated by the anterior pituitary hormone ACTH. In the next step, pregnenolone is converted to progesterone. Next, we will move horizontally and observe the 17 α-hydroxylation reaction happening. That is, hydroxyl groups will be added at 17 alpha position so that pregnenolone is converted to 17 alpha hydroxypregnenolone and progesterone is converted to 17 alpha hydroxyprogesterone. Since hydroxylation is happening at the 17 alpha position, the enzyme catalyzing these reactions is 17 alpha hydroxylase. Now we move further horizontally and observe that 17 alpha hydroxypregnenolone is converted to DHEA or dihydroepiandrosterone, and 17 alpha hydroxyprogesterone is converted to androstenedione. The enzyme catalyzing these reactions is 17-20 lyase. As the name suggests, it breaks the 17-20 bond and therefore converts the 21-carbon compounds to the 19-carbon compounds. These 19-carbon compounds are DHEA and androstenedione, which are the androgen precursors. Now we start moving vertically downwards, so that first, the conversion of pregnenolone to progesterone on the left side. Second, the conversion of 17-alpha-hydroxypregnenolone to 17-alpha-hydroxyprogesterone in the middle column, and the conversion of DHEA to androstenedione in the right column are all catalyzed by the same enzyme 3-beta hydroxysteroid dehydrogenase. So far, so good. Okay, so moving on and going further vertically down. Progesterone is converted to 11-deoxycorticosterone and 17-alpha-hydroxyprogesterone is converted to 11-deoxycortisol. We can remember this, that in both these reactions, the word deoxy comes in and they become deoxy compounds. We can observe that the mineralocorticoids have the letters O-N-E, on at the end. So it has the name deoxycorticosterone, while glucocorticoids have the letters O-L, all at the end. So it has the name deoxycortisol. Both these reactions are catalyzed by the enzyme 21-alpha-hydroxylase. This is an important enzyme. Now in the next step, the word deoxy goes away. So deoxycorticosterone becomes corticosterone and 11-deoxycortisol becomes cortisol. Both these reactions are catalyzed by another important enzyme, 11-beta-hydroxylase. Now, the glucocorticoid pathway ends here. Cortisol, also called hydrocortisone, is the main glucocorticoid synthesized in the body. We will now continue with the mineralocorticoid pathway. So on the left side, corticosterone gets converted to 18-hydroxycorticosterone and then 18-hydroxycorticosterone finally gets converted to aldosterone. Both these reactions are catalyzed by the enzyme 11-beta-hydroxylase. The enzyme 11-beta-hydroxylase catalyzing the last step is also called aldosterone synthase. This last step is stimulated by a compound called angiotensin II. So, in the end, we observe that the main mineralocorticoid secreted by the adrenal gland is aldosterone, the main glucocorticoid secreted by the adrenal gland is cortisol or hydrocortisone, and the main androgenic precursor secreted by the adrenal gland is DHEA or dehydroepiandrosterone. These are all shown in green background. The important enzymes in this pathway that we need to specifically remember are 17-alpha-hydroxylase, 21-alpha-hydroxylase, and 11-beta-hydroxylase. In the next video, we will discuss the deficiency of these important enzymes in this adrenal pathway and their clinical manifestations. Thanks for watching. If you find the information in this video beneficial, do like, share, and subscribe this video.